Octopuses are soft-bodied marine mollusks. They are part of a class of organisms called cephalopods that also includes animals like squid and cuttlefish. Around 300 species of octopuses are recognized. They are bilaterally symmetrical invertebrates with 8 arms surrounding their mouth. Although all octopuses share many things in common, their size, location, hunting, swimming, and mating habits can vary widely, depending on the species. There is so much that is not yet known about these unique creatures. With their complex nervous system, they are among the most intelligent of all invertebrates. They can be found in all of the world's oceans. Most species live in relatively shallow areas in tropical and temperate waters. Some live in extreme environments, such as near hydrothermal vents, thousands of feet below the surface. Others live in deep, frigid polar waters. Most inhabit the seafloor on sandy bottoms, coral reefs, or tide pools, while others live a pelagic lifestyle at sea. Most species have no internal shell, and the only hard part of their body is their parrot-like beak, allowing them to ooze through tiny cracks. All are venomous, but only the blue-ringed octopus is known to be deadly to humans by releasing their powerful, paralyzing toxin with their bite. Depending on the species, they may grow to be less than an inch, or, in the case of the giant Pacific octopus, reach a maximum reported length of 30 feet across. The interior of their arms is covered with adhesive suckers. The suckers allow the octopus to cling to and manipulate objects. Their arms can even taste what they touch. Some deep-sea species also have webbing along their arms. Each octopus has 3 hearts. One heart pumps blood around their body, while the other 2 hearts pump blood through their gills. Their blood is copper-based instead of iron-based, making their blood blue. The copper-based blood is more efficient at transporting oxygen when ocean temperatures are low and oxygen is limited. Octopuses have a siphon that they can use for things like respiration, swimming by jet propulsion, and discharging ink. Some species have large fins that they rely on for swimming. They have good memory and problem-solving abilities. The majority of their neurons are located in their arms. Each arm can move independently of one another. They can navigate through mazes and open jars from the inside and out. They are very sensitive to the ocean's pH, which may cause them to be negatively impacted by ocean acidification in the future. Plenty of animals like to prey on octopuses. This includes animals like sharks, barracudas, moray eels, groupers, seals, and birds. To survive, octopuses have multiple lines of defense. Species that live on the seafloor can camouflage themselves by changing what they look like instantaneously. They do this by expanding and contracting tiny pigment sacs in their skin called chromatophores. They can also change their skin's texture. Some species, like the mimic octopus, can even camouflage themselves and take on the behavior of an animal that is less palatable, like a lionfish. If an octopus knows that they are in trouble, they can confuse their predator and make a quick escape by squirting a jet of ink. The ink also dulls the predator's sense of smell. If they do happen to lose an arm, it can be regrown. Nocturnal and deep-sea octopuses tend to not have the same efficiency of color-changing displays as bottom-dwelling daytime octopuses, and they're more likely to remain one color. Some deep-sea octopuses have bioluminescent spots. An octopus's diet typically consists of crabs, mollusks, and fish. Some species crawl along the ocean floor, sticking their arms into small openings to search for food. They may pull the shells of their prey apart, or drill a hole through the shell and inject their venomous saliva. The entrance of their home is often marked by piles of discarded shells. An octopus's home is typically a den that they build from rocks or simply a crevice on the seafloor. They might even make a door for their den by pulling a rock into place once they are inside. Some species live in shells, and others hide in sand. Most species live solitary lives, only seeking company when it's time to mate. Their color-changing abilities can also be used to communicate with other octopuses. Most species only mate once, and then die shortly after, only living a year or two. Typically, males transfer sperm by inserting a specially modified arm called the hectocotylus into the mantle cavity of the female. The male dies shortly after mating. The female carefully takes care of and guards her eggs until they hatch. She aerates the eggs and keeps them clean. Females usually do not feed during this time. Egg quantity and size varies by species. A female octopus may lay anywhere from 50 large eggs to tens of thousands of small eggs. Eggs are usually laid in clusters. Shallow water octopuses typically lay their eggs in their den. Smaller octopuses may lay their eggs inside clamshells or rubbish. Some species may simply carry their eggs with them. Some even make up a coiled egg case to deposit and drift with their eggs. Upon hatching, octopus young may float to the surface to live as plankton until they grow large enough to settle. In species with larger eggs, the hatchlings start their life on the bottom right away. Females die shortly after their eggs hatch. Octopuses have been around for millions of years. Due to their soft tissues, octopus fossils are hard to come by. The oldest described octopus fossil is about 296 million years old. In many parts of the world, eating octopus is considered a delicacy. They may be eaten raw, live, or cooked. The most frequently consumed octopus is the common octopus. For more marine facts, click the subscribe button.